Hello students, welcome to the second part of this chapter 18, that is economic presence of the government. So I'm going to continue from those subtopics that I've left out in the previous class. That is, today I'm going to explain about the industrial development, and then I will explain about the government efforts to reduce the poverty, also the government efforts to reduce unemployment in the country. And in the final topic, I will explain to you about how the price rise can be controlled, all right? So I'm dealing with the economic presence of the government. I've explained to you that economy is so important because it is the first step to bring advancement in every state in India, right? Now in 2015, on 1st of January, the government of India has introduced this Niti Aayog, which has replaced the Planning Commission. All right. So earlier it was the Planning Commission, but now it has been replaced by Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog means the National Institution for Transforming India. All right. And here it is headed by the Prime Ministers, along with the Chief Ministers of the State and the late Governors of the United Nations of India. All right. Now, this group of people, they have formed these five-year plans, and in these five-year plans, they used to set up industries, factories, schools, they set up some dams and multi-purpose projects, and all this led to the advancements of Indian country as a whole, all right? Now, I've explained to you about the agricultural developments. Now, I'm going to continue from the next subtopic, that is industrial development. So even in industry also, a lot of developments have come up, just like how developments have taken place in agriculture, right? If you remember, I've explained to you about the agricultural developments where the raw materials has been improved, and with the help of this improvement in raw materials, the technologies are used, the soil has been improved, then manures and fertilizers are improved. So all this led to development in agriculture. Similarly, even in industry also, a lot of developments came up. One was the iron and steel, okay? So when India became free, there were two major units for delivering iron and steel. And today we have so many steel plants in different parts of India, like in Bokaro, we have Jamshedpur, in Silam and Bhadravati, all right? Now in page number 146, you will see that the HMT has also come up. It is a factory and it creates about 1,000 watches every day, all right? Then we have the Heavy Engineering Corporation. Today it is at Ranchi and it used to provide supply cement, sugar, textile and iron to different parts of India. And we have the fertilizer industry. They used to they have the processing plants in public sector and they help to increase the production by utilizing these chemical fertilizers. So with the help of these chemical fertilizers, the people who are doing the agriculture, there has been a lot of benefit for them because it used to kill the pest and it also helps the crops in their plantation, in their growth, right? Now next is the drug and the pharmaceuticals industry. We have the antibiotic plants at Rishikesh, the Hindustan Antibiotics at Pimpri, which is in Pune, and we also have the Hindustan Insecticides factory in Delhi. And apart from that, we have the heavy electricals in heavy electricals in Bhopal and Bharatpur, and where these they used to provide generators, transformers, water turbines, and steam turbines. And coming to the seventh one, you see that it's mineral and oil industry, right? So we have different mineral and oil industry in Barauni, in Madras, in Haldia, and in Mathura. So the government gave emphasis to exploring, drilling, and refining of the mineral oil. And the government has set up several industries to make India a great and an industrial nation, all right? So these are the industries. They are located in different parts of India. So suppose if one state provides all those drugs, then they are being supplied to different parts of India. Then if those iron and steel, which are being produced in one part of India are being supplied to different parts of India. With that, there is a balance and there is a lot of improvement, right? Now coming to the next point, that is, what are the efforts that the government has made in order to improve the lives of these people in the poverty line, all right? Number one is employment opportunities. So when this industrial development came up, a lot of people got employed in industries and factories, right? Earlier, there was only these government jobs, or people, whoever have their land, they used to do farming, they have their own gardens. So they depend on these food products, whichever they get from the land. And apart from that, they don't have any other sources to earn money, right? But when these factories were set up, when the schools were set up, when the industries were set up, many people were employed there. And though this is a private sector, yet they're also getting a good salary, and it is helping them in sustaining themselves, right? Now, next effort that was made by the government is the development of agriculture. So every year, the population of India is increasing, and in order to meet the demands of this huge population, improving the agriculture was very important. So the government has tried to improve this agriculture by giving them free seeds to the farmers. A proper way of agriculture, proper way of farming is also being taught. They are given training, they are given free trainings also. So all this has led to the improvement of agriculture, and in return, it is helping this huge population of India to balance themselves, right? Then the third one is the fair price and transportation. So the government of India have also set up national highways, and they have also improved the road conditions, whether it's roadways, waterways, railways and airways. So all these means of transportation has been improved, and that has also helped in reducing poverty, all right? Because the foods are being supplied to different states easily, and it is also improving the people in the poverty line. Now, number four is the encouraging industrial development. So the government of India is also encouraging the private sectors to set up industries and companies, so that along with the government industries and factories, they will also link with the private factories and industries, and together they will work for the betterment of the country, right? Then number five is the family planning. So they're trying to mainly focus on family planning so that the population explosion can be controlled, right? Then the next one is the five-year plans. I've already explained to you about what is a five-year plans, where in these five-year plans, a lot of discussion is done by all the top leaders of the country, and then they decide for the betterment of the country, right? Then another is the food security scheme. Here, this scheme has a long way in helping a lot of people who remain hungry, undernourished, and malnourished due to the low purchasing power. There are about 4 lakh fair price shops. Now, these fair price shops, what they do? They used to supply goods at a very cheap rate, okay? So because of these cheap goods, the ones who are in the poverty line, they are also able to buy it and eat it, right? Now, the last one is under the integrated child development scheme, mothers and children below the age of 6 years, children below the age of 6 years, and the mother who are going to conceive a child, right? They are given food materials. And even in government schools, are also the midday meals are provided to the children, right? So all this has helped to improve the life of the ones who are in the poverty line, all right? Now, coming to the next point, that is the government efforts to reduce unemployment. So the government is also trying its best to help those unemployed youths and unemployed families, right? So one of the scheme that the government has started is to give certain amount of money to those people who are educated, who are skillful, yet they do not have support from their family to start their own business, all right? So the government gives an amount of 25,000 rupees, and with the help of this money, they set up their shops, or they set up their startups, all right? So with the help of that money, suppose a person is very skillful in making baskets, very skillful in making things, goods, with the help of bamboos, so that they will bring those materials and whatever is required to set up this, to make these things, they will bring with that money and they will start, right? So with the help of that, they will be able to not only earn, but in the meantime, they will also pay back all the loans, whichever they have taken from the bank through the government help, right? So likewise, a lot of schemes have also come up where even the older men and women are also given a certain amount of money so they can use it for buying things and starting a certain business in order to sustain, in order to look after their family, all right? So we have the Nehru Rozgar Yojana, then there are also Jawahar Rozgar Yojana. So these are the schemes of the government in order to help the unemployed people, right? Then another one is they give free training to those youths who are skillful, yet they do not have enough money to go for training. So training for electricity, training for as an electrician, training for making baskets, or training for making, for weaving, all these trainings are given free of cost. And with the help of this training, the youths can, after they are done with this training, they can go about and they can start their own business using their skills. Say, for example, if the person have learned how to make, how to do weaving, so they will learn this through this free training course from the government. And once they are done, they will also weave, and then they will sell their goods in the market, right? So they will make money, and it also helps them in unemployed, right? So another is the employment assurance scheme. This was launched in 1994, especially to help the backward classes of the country, right? Then there is this Prime Minister's Integrated Urban Poverty Eradication Program. This was implemented in 1995, and this program aims to provide employment to the urban poor. It will cover 50 lakh urban poor living in 345 towns. So it is a big program, all right? So likewise, the government has also imposed certain schemes. They have also started up certain trainings in order to help the youths. Not only that, but they also provide money in terms of loans. And then in return, they can also do their own startups, all right? So coming to the control of price rise. So how the government is controlling the price rise? One of the thing is they are avoiding unnecessary deficit financing. So sometimes there are too many surplus corns, and sometimes there are less because of certain natural calamities. So what happens is whenever they have too much food products, they store it in certain place, and whenever they have shortage, they used to take it out, and in that way they try to balance, all right? So that is one thing. Then the next one is restricting disposable money incomes in the hands of consumers. So timely, they used to check on those consumers and producers who are not doing their work properly. Like for example, if a person is going to the farmer directly, getting the goods from there, and then selling off the goods at a very high price in other markets, right? So government tried to keep a check on them so that there will be a balance, and then everybody will get the goods at a fair price, right? At a reasonable price, all right? Okay, so the fourth one is distribution, public distribution system. So in order to ensure a continuous supply of essential goods of the mass consumption to people at reasonable rates, the government opens ration shops and starts super bazaars. So through these bazaars and shops, the people get goods at a very cheap rate, at a very reasonable rate, comparing to the other markets, all right? So that is also one way of controlling the price rise. Then next one is introduction of a system and dual marketing for controlling the price rise. Sometimes the government resorts to a system of dual marketing. Under this system, what they do is certain items like sugar, wheat, rice, etc. are supplied to the people at two points, one at the fair price shops and other one at the fixed rate. So at the other at the general and the shops at a higher So with the help of this two distribution, it also creates a balance in the price rise, all right? The next is actions against hooders, smugglers, and black marketers. So there are certain people who used to buy these goods at a huge bulk, and then later on, they used to sell it off at a very high price where the common people are not able to buy, afford it, all right? So the government also keeps a check on that, all right? Then the next one is giving various incentives to producers to improve the supply line. So the government is also giving incentives to the suppliers by giving them good skillful technologies, also by suggesting them good agriculture products, right? So with the help of that, they're also getting, it is a one way to check the price rise. And in order to ensure, the government tries to give all sorts of incentives and then which would lead to industrial revival and also improve the supply of the manufactured goods. Then coming to the last one, that is resorting to imports if certain essential items are in short supply in the country. So in order to improve the supply position of certain essential commodities, the government often allows the import. And so whenever there is shortage of supplies in India, the government makes sure that the country do not supply to any other countries. So whenever there is only excess, they're allowed to be imported, or else if the country faces losses, or if the country also needs these products, and if there is shortage, then the government makes sure that these things are not imported to any other countries. So these are the ways where the government try to check the price rise, all right? So remember, in this lesson, I've explained to you about the economic development, why it is so important, and then the government has also set up a planning commission. Earlier, it was known as the planning commission, but now it is known as Niti Aayog, and it was started on 1st January 1995, all right, by the top leaders of the country. They have set up these five-year plans, and under these five-year plans, so many multi-purpose projects has been set up, like the Bhakra Nangal project, the Hirakud project, right? So through these projects, the Indian states have received a good amount of water for irrigation and also electricity on those areas where there is no water, right? And then not only that, but it has also controlled floods, and it has also controlled the shortage of water. And since India is an agricultural land, a lot of water is required for production of crops, for growth of plants, right? So these dams have been a lifesaver for the agriculturalist, all right? Then I have explained to you about the development of industrial industries in India, where the government is also supporting them in order to improve by supporting them with good technologies. And the government is also encouraging those companies and factories to start up those, to make those good and skillful products, which will help in agriculture and also in many areas in order to advance, in order to improve the condition of economy, all right? Then there are certain government efforts to reduce the poverty, as well as the government efforts to give employment to the youth and also to those families who suffer from financial problems, right? And then the government has also set up different initiatives. The government has taken up initiatives in order to control the price rise and inflation problems, all right? So that's all in this chapter. Thank you so much. Keep studying, and all the best for your exams. Thank you.